optimization, and marginal analysis. Central assumptions and typical economic approaches to thinking about behavior include economic agents being rational and self-interested. So economic agents are seen as having an objective or overarching goal. Classically, firms are modeled as desiring profits and individuals as seeking utility. But being rational and self-interested implies more than just desiring these objectives. It implies doing the best for yourself as you can. In other words, standard economic approaches emphasize optimization. How do firms maximize profits? How do individuals maximize utility? These are complicated because there are constraints. Maximizing profit isn't the same as maximizing revenue. Rather, a firm needs to weigh the costs required to generate additional revenue. Maximizing utility isn't the same as maximizing consumption. Rather, an individual needs to weigh the sacrifices needed to afford consumption. In other words, firms try to maximize profits while facing market constraints, while individuals try to maximize utility while facing a budget constraint and a time constraint. So economic agents face constrained optimization problems. When solved correctly, this results in optimal behaviors, and in common notation, the optimal value is indicated by an asterisk. The optimal amount of labor to hire, L star, is part of the firm's solution to its profit maximization constrained optimization problem. The optimal amount of hours to work, H star, is part of an individual's solution to their utility maximization constrained optimization problem. So how to find the optimal solution? The key is marginal analysis. We will use marginal analysis throughout this course. Behind this lies some standard math, but we can take an intuitive approach. In common English, marginal has different meanings. Some meanings pertain to not of central importance or barely exceeding requirements, as in, this piggy bank is of marginal quality. But in economics, the focus is on margin, as in the edge or outer border of something. So we're trying to make a decision on the boundary, on the margin. For example, suppose I typically work 8 hours a day. 8 hours is therefore the edge or outer border of my work time, and marginal analysis focuses on whether I should push that edge a small amount and work a little bit more. Or, marginal effort isn't effort of barely acceptable quality, it's the next unit of incremental effort that would result if I worked just a bit harder. From a firm's perspective, a marginal worker isn't a bad worker, it's the extra worker hired if the firm added one more worker. The key to marginal analysis is thinking about the additional benefit or gain from one more unit of whatever we're contemplating and the additional cost or loss associated with one more unit. If I'm thinking about working for one more hour and I'm focused on monetary benefits, then the additional benefit would be how much I get paid for that additional hour. But spending one more hour working is one less hour I can spend doing other things. So there's also a cost, which depends on how valuable those other activities are to me. In economics jargon, we call these the marginal benefit and marginal cost, often abbreviated MB and MC. As an example from the firm's perspective, the marginal benefit of hiring one more worker is the value of the additional productivity gain, and the marginal cost is the additional labor cost involved to hire and pay the worker. But remember what we're trying to do. We're trying to think about how the worker, for example, determines the optimal number of hours to work, or how the firm determines the optimal number of workers to hire. The optimal decision boils down to a comparison of the marginal cost and marginal benefit. So we are using marginal analysis. Let's look at this graphically. The quantity of something, like hours of work, work effort, or number of workers, is on the horizontal axis, dollars on the vertical. As we do more of something, it's conventional to assume that we don't get increasing benefit. More likely, we get declining additional value. The fourth slice of pizza is good, but not quite as good as the first. So the marginal benefit curve is decreasing, or at least flat. Not increasing. Similarly, the marginal cost curve is not decreasing. Maybe you can buy as much pizza as you want for the same additional cost, so the marginal cost curve would be flat. But if you want to hire more and more workers, you might have to increase your wage at some point, in which case the marginal cost curve would slope upwards. Suppose the marginal benefit is greater than the marginal cost. For a pizza lover, the benefit of one slice is greater than the cost, so it's beneficial to buy that first slice. As an aside, remember that economics assumes that agents are rational and value money. So an economic agent can translate activities into monetary or utility equivalents. like determining that the value of the first slice of pizza translates to $10 in value. But back to the main story. As long as the marginal benefit is greater than the marginal cost, an economic agent should do more of whatever is being contemplated: eating pizza, working a certain number of hours, hiring workers. Now consider the opposite situation, that is, the marginal cost greater than the marginal benefit. In this case, hiring one more worker is more expensive than the value they bring to the organization, or the cost of working an additional hour, say because of extra stress or missed leisure time, is more costly than the value of the pay you'd earn working that hour. As long as the marginal cost is greater than the marginal benefit, an economic agent should do less of whatever is being contemplated. So then what's optimal? To do something up to the point where the marginal benefit equals the marginal cost. At that point, it would be harmful to do more, but missing an opportunity if you did less. It's sort of a Goldilocks situation. Not too little, not too much, but just right. So where the marginal benefit equals the marginal cost, the optimal quantity is Q star. This is a very useful result because for whatever optimization problem we want to consider, how much pizza to eat, how many hours to work, how many workers to hire, we can always use the marginal benefit equals the marginal cost to characterize the optimum, all without ever doing the calculus that lies behind it. Make sure you understand the logic of marginal analysis. We will use the optimum rule of the marginal benefit equals the marginal cost repeatedly throughout this course in predicting how we expect economically oriented workers to behave and how firms should set optimal compensation policies and think about other HR practices when managing economically oriented workers.